Discernment and integrity. As we journey in life, we may notice lots of people that we perceive to be out of integrity. And we might want them to be in greater degrees of integrity, to be kind to each other, to respect the planet, to do what they say they're going to do, to be honest, to be kind. Integrity has lots of layers to it. And so, whenever we are wanting for other people to be in integrity, explore the idea that you're placing your attachment and your desire on that person, wanting them to be in integrity. And I'm just going to invite you to take a deep breath in, to pull your energy and awareness into your divine line, to invite your higher self, your body, to higher self and teams to work with the energetic fields and the guides to feel into any attachment threads, energetic lines that you have going outside yourself onto other people, wanting other people to be in integrity. All these little attachment nuggets out on other people, wanting them to be in integrity. And as you feel into all of those lines going out, wanting them to be in integrity, explore the idea that just placing attachment out on other people, wanting them to be in integrity, is actually out of integrity. So you are no longer in integrity because you're projecting that which you value onto another. And so if you value integrity, you can actually use that strength of valuing integrity to move into greater degrees of integrity and invite your higher self, body, divas, higher self teams to lift all of that attachment off of everyone and everything, bringing all of that attachment, that desire off of them back to you, only attached and wanting for your own integrity. Walk the walk. A lot of people talk the walk, but don't walk the walk. So we've got all of this attachment, this desire for integrity only on self. And then take a moment to invite your higher self, body, divas, higher self, and teams to spin your fields in a counterclockwise direction, returning all responsibility and all empathic sensations and all karma that went with you being attached and wanting for them. Anytime we get attached, then we start holding responsibility, then we start getting empathically impacted, and then we start possibly even processing their karma. So invite your higher self, body, divas, higher self, and teams to spin your fields in that counterclockwise direction, returning, returning, returning all bundles of responsibility, all empathic sensations, all karma of everyone you were ever attached to, being in integrity, giving it back to them at the level of their higher selves, where they have the capacity to receive it, sending appropriate energetic information. And then as you return it, then explore the idea that some part of you has energetically placed your fabric of integrity, which has a huge resource to it, incredible support, positive karma. You place your fabric of integrity on them. Invite your higher self, body, divas, higher self teams to retrieve your fabric of integrity off of everyone and everything, cleaning it, recalibrating it, reweaving it back in your own field, spinning your fields in a clockwise direction, retrieving your fabric of integrity back on self, using it to support you, buffer you, protect you, and then give you greater discernment about where someone is in their journey. Because one of the layers of integrity is having high levels of awareness and discernment of where someone is, why they do what they do, because of where they are at this point in time in their evolution, their priorities. And when souls are not very aware, self-evolved, they will value different things. They might value control, they might value power, they might not value kindness and integrity. And so, the more you're holding your fabric of integrity on yourself that buffers you, gives you a clarity, a distance, that well, it really gives you a buffer, which then gives you distance, which then gives you clarity, which then gives you discernment. And then we're not as reactive. We get reactive when we have not been holding appropriate discernment. So, the other layer to this is anytime you get disappointed, play with the idea you've had inappropriate expectations because you were lacking discernment, because you didn't have the clarity, because you might not have been holding your integrity bubble on you. So lots of layers to discernment, integrity, and again, short recap of how to cultivate more discernment, how to be in greater degrees of integrity. Deep breath in. Only attached to you being in integrity, no one else on the planet. No one in any dimension, only attached to your own integrity. Holding your fabric of integrity entirely on you, using it to buffer you, support you, protect you. Give you a distance, which gives you clarity, which then enables you to discern what's really being asked for in the moment. And then you also have the ability to move from a place of greater kindness, gentleness, grace, coaching, encouraging, positively, empathically impacting others by not wanting for them. Oh. Updating all your grids, all your reference points, all ways in which you perceive. Letting that integrate.